Good morning, President Taylor and members of the board. I will start by thanking our CalPERS team members who worked together to host our third Pathways for Women's Conference that was held last month in Anaheim. This year's event was a success, I think, on several levels. So let me just share a few of the data points. We had more than 500 people in attendance, with attendees coming from 12 different states. 83% of the attendees described themselves as either mid or late career. So I think we have an opportunity here to recruit more early career attendees in the future. We even had a few retirees attend, along with a higher percentage of men when compared to attendance at our last Pathways conference in 2022. That's encouraging because we know more male coaches and allies and sponsors to lend their voices to supporting women. From the outset, there was a great sense of excitement at the event. This was, again, an event focused on women's careers, and sometimes those are unique in relationship to their male counterparts. One of the most special aspects of Pathways is that it allows women to be with their peers, sharing experiences and advice. There's a lot of positive energy in that kind of environment, an energy that gets people to open up and really engage. Again, thank you to everyone who made the event possible. The educational forum, we're celebrating 25 years of partnership with our public employers. Just briefly reminding everyone that this year's educational forum takes place October 28th through the 30th, and that will be held at the Town and Country Resort in San Diego. Again, it is the 25th year for an event that is an essential part of working with our employer partners to strengthen their CalPERS processes. More than 1,000 attendees have already signed up, and registration will remain open until October 4th. Past attendees have praised the value of in-person education and having one-on-one conversations with our team members to get questions answered. The schedule offers programming that provides a look into the administration of CalPERS benefits. The forum also gives us an opportunity to celebrate public sector heroes through our annual Spotlight on Excellence Award. This year, we have a little bit of a surprise in store for the awards, so stay tuned for more information on that. And we are also excited to welcome as our keynote speaker, Kath Cashel. She's an award-winning author and founder of The Kindness Factory, and she has used her own story as motivation to focus on the power of positivity. We dedicate significant time and resources to this conference every year because our partnership with employers is so important to our collective success on behalf of our members. So I did want to spend a bit of time this morning talking about climate data reporting, and I think that's an area that CalPERS has been focused on for several years, and I think we often lose sight of the successes that have really happened around transparency. So I'm going to spend a little bit of time walking through some of those accomplishments. So serving our members is also why we do work so hard to make good investment decisions. And that's why I want to share a few thoughts again this morning on the work to improve and expand our climate-aware investing. Later this month, several CalPERS investment team members will attend the annual, annual events in New York known as Climate Week. Climate Week presents an opportunity to acknowledge both the successes and the setbacks in responding to the impacts of a warming climate. Responding to climate change is essential to our fiduciary duty. Being climate aware ensures that CalPERS' investments can stand the test of time, providing long-term benefits to our members and their families. That's why we have spent years as advocates for clear and consistent information about how climate change is affecting the value of our investments. That information is key to measuring risk, both the kind of risk to avoid and the risk that, if we fully understand it, can be harnessed to achieve higher returns. We are encouraged by efforts to improve corporate transparency, both in California as well as across the globe. In California, there's considerable interest in two new state laws, one that requires large corporations to disclose their greenhouse gas emissions beginning in 2026, the other requiring companies to report their climate-related financial risks. Both laws have ended up in court, and CalPERS has submitted a formal declaration in the case in support of these laws, part of a growing wave of climate transparency. 3 years ago, CalPERS launched helped to launch a data convergence initiative for the private markets. That effort has now been embraced by investors with more than $38 trillion in assets under management. CalPERS was also a founding member of Climate Action 100 Plus, an organization dedicated to providing actionable climate data. We know there's been a lot of noise about the organization's membership, but we remain squarely focused on its mission. These efforts are paying off. Transparency is already making our investing more climate aware. We are doing more than just protecting our portfolio from shifting weather patterns and ravages of fires or floods. We are also leaning in and investing in climate solutions. This is a key part of our Sustainable Investments 2030 plan. Our team reports about $2.6 billion in new climate investing since formally launching their effort last November. And deals currently in the pipeline and under consideration could possibly double that amount in the next few months. The completed investments are mostly in programs to mitigate the impacts of climate change. We also are making investments in climate adaptations and climate transitions. These investments depend on the kind of clear, detailed investor data that will continue, that we will continue to champion. In our work, as in much of life, knowledge is power, and that knowledge is necessary to make climate-aware decisions. We applaud those who have joined our effort to be climate aware. The stakes are simply too high for our investments and our members to sit on the sidelines. President Taylor, that does conclude my report, but I'm happy to take questions.